Welcome to Part 2 of UnityConnect Training. As we learned in Part 1, UnityConnect can capture data using different methods. This video only applies to those using the data file method. We recommend that you move on to Part 3 if you're not using the data file method. Let's get a better understanding of how UnityConnect can capture data using a data file. At their laboratory system, the operator generates QC data. Depending on the make and model of the laboratory system, the data might be saved to a floppy disk, CD, flash drive, or a folder located on a local or network drive. The QC data can then be picked up by UnityConnect. At this point, you might be wondering what a data file should contain. A QC data file should contain data for all instruments, controls, levels, and tests. A common question is, how do I make a file? When the process to get connected started, someone in your organization submitted a QC data file to Bio-Rad. We created a connectivity solution based on that sample file format. It's critical that your subsequent QC data files are in the same format as the initial sample. While your laboratory system may be able to generate files in a different format, your connectivity solution will not recognize it. If you don't know how to create a QC data file, we recommend speaking to your coworker who generated the initial file. Bio-Rad also hosts step-by-step directions on qcnet.com for many of the most common systems. Feel free to contact your Bio-Rad representative if you need additional help. In some cases, the manufacturer of your laboratory system can also be of assistance. The first time you create a QC data file, you might want to verify that you've captured everything. You'll need to take caution when opening the file, as some formats can be altered by opening them. We recommend that you copy the file and open it instead of the original. You'll need to create a QC data file at least once a month. However, many labs choose to create QC data files more often in order to monitor their QC more frequently. Continue your training by viewing Part 3.